Here we are today with one of our mentors who is going to be joining us for the encounter. We're here with Father Jason. How are you, Father?
Doing just fine, thank you.
Good, good to know. Well, first of all, we want to ask you, can you tell us a little bit about your district?
I've been a priest now for about 3 years, and I come from District 12. I mean, basically the church where I served, last three churches, it's mining country and also ranchers. I still got my cowboy boots on from there, but I've recently moved and now I am closer to the capital here. In fact, I am maybe in the capital here at Ascension Parish.
Right. And we want to know, how have you been preparing yourself for the past, let's say, years?
Before I was even a priest, I was a part of a movement of university students. I was seeking God in college. Then I was mentored by a guy and it changed my entire life. Then God called me to be a priest. God calls normal guys, you know, God calls guys to the priest so they're just normal.
Normal priests who wear boots, right?
Yeah, that's right. that's so normal, I guess.
And one of our last questions.
Yeah.
When was that situation where you were in a hunger situation?
You know, I love the theme of this conference. I think it's just wonderful because I think back when I was in high school and I was hungry. And the reason why I was hungry is because I was suffering a lot in my life. My parents had just been divorced. And I struggled. I had horrible acne in high school. So I was struggling and I was living. I didn't like my mom remarried a guy. I didn't like him. So I was living in my dad's one bedroom apartment with my twin brother, sleeping on the floor. I still do that because I learned it there. And I was looking for something. And I was looking for meaning. You know, it's like so much of us were distracted by all the attachments to, you know, and especially in today's world where we have cell phones and television, all these distractions, right? Well, I found my release in sports. I was a cross country runner, but you have a lot of time to think in that. And you also have to suffer a lot. And if you don't have a better reason to do it, you're not gonna do it. But I was suffering through my family situation and through the sports. I grew through my friends there, but I still noticed that there's something else that was missing. I was getting great grades, had some good friends, but there's something that was missing. And I would try to be a good person. I remember in high school, I'd take the yearbook and I'd try to cry for every single person in the yearbook. I was one of those people who would try to be a good person. I loved to do service work, but what did I find? I would always fail people and people would fail me. And I couldn't be the person I wanted. I had this hunger, right? For something more than just pleasure and money. I wanted meaning. I wanted like real love in my life. I wanted innocence. I desired that innocence that I had as a child and I couldn't find it. And I looked into religion and where did I find it? In Christians? No, the Christians were sinning more than I was, you know? And so I was like looking for them. I ended up finding some later, but at the time, the people I saw that were most impressive was my best friend who was Jewish and a buddy who was Hindu. And he became a monk out of high school. So I learned Buddhist meditation. I'd go down by the creek and meditate. But part of meditation is trying to separate yourself from this world. And I couldn't kill that hunger that God really wanted me to engage him and that the world really wasn't all bad, it was good. But I didn't find that until I was actually in Mexico. And I went down, I knew some Christians and they invited me to go on a mission trip. And they knew I wasn't practicing, but they're like, wanna come with me? I was like, I love service work, I wanna learn Spanish, so cool. So I went down to Tamaulipas in Ciudad Mante, about 6 hours south of the border. And we arrive in the middle of the night, you know, you're having all the check guards, you have guards with machine guns getting on the bus throughout the night. And we show up and I work in an orphanage. I was there for just about a week. But it was Holy Week. And here it is, you can imagine, are you a parent yourself?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I am not a parent.
She's eligible. but you know how families are stressful. You know, you probably have struggles in your family. Well, imagine two parents with 30 kids.
Oh, wow.
Most of them have been abused. And so they like, their noses are running because their parents made them sniff things so they wouldn't be hungry, right? They wouldn't be hungry, but what did you find? A deeper hunger. These kids that didn't have anything were the happiest kids I've ever seen. And they were the most well-behaved. The 12-year-olds were leading the prayers for everybody else.
Wow.
And they were super disciplined. And I was planting trees, they would help me out. All the little kids were fighting to help me. And I started seeing, these kids are different. Why? Because they don't have any of the physical things, but they have God in their life. And I was thinking about that, maybe. I didn't quite put two and two together, but I was praying about it. One of the guys challenged me. He's like, do you really believe in Jesus? You know, like, where are you at with Jesus, Jason? Because I was like, he's cool. I like Jesus.
Jesus is cool.
Jesus is cool. But he's like, is he your God? Are you willing to have him? And I was like, not quite there. You know, like Muhammad has his qualities. The Buddha has his qualities. But then I started to say, wow, is Christianity really different? And at that moment, I took the scriptures, and first of all, and I opened my Bible for the first time, and I read the Beatitudes, Matthew 5. Blessed are the poor in spirit, right? They shall be satisfied. Blessed are those who, the kingdom of God is theirs. Blessed are those who hunger, right? And thirst for righteousness, that's later. Blessed are those who mourn. I saw these kids hungry, mourning. They were struggling. They wanted people in their life. They were poor, but guess what? They were happy. The Beatitudes, happy are the ones who. Why are you happy? Because they didn't have material things, but what they had was meaning in life, because they had Jesus. I was trying. I recognized my hunger, and I was trying to fulfill it by my own effort. But what I realized is I could never do that. God had to come to me. And so God came to me, and at that moment, I really opened my light, my heart to Jesus Christ. And from that moment, everything changed.
Great.
Yeah, that was the moment I found a fulfillment to that deeper hunger in Jesus, and from then led on a path to almost directly into the Catholic Church, and now eventually to be a missionary, and now
here you are.
Here I am.
Well, we're excited to have you for our encounter.
It's awesome. Looking forward to it.
We'll see what you have to say to us.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right.